Hi, I'm Terry White, and I'm here with the new Westcott Skylux LED continuous lighting, and more importantly, for this quick tip, the new modern vintage backdrops. So this tip is on controlling your depth of field. We're gonna make it really quick. There's two main ways to do it. One, depth of field is automatic just by moving the background further away from your subject. However, if you're in a tight space, tight, small studio, don't have the liberty of moving the subject that far off the background, then you really need to control it with your f-stop. So we took four shots. We did f5.6, f3.5, and of course, that's the range of most kit lenses. So we're gonna take a look at those shots in just a moment. But then we also did f2.8 and f1.4. Now, those are the better lenses, and questions I get all the time are, well, why should I pay that much for a lens? This is one of the reasons you want to pay that much for a lens. Not only do you get to shoot in a darker location, but you also get to control your depth of field better. So let's take a look at those shots. Here's the first one at f5.6, and as you can see the pattern of the background. Now, while that's great, it may be distracting for your subject. So let's go to f3.5, and as you can see, the background's starting to fade away. And now, let's look at the better lens. Let's look at the f2.8. And here, this is almost the sweet spot. This is what I like, where the background is there, the pattern's there, but it's not dominating the subject. It's just out of focus enough to where I can see it, but not distracting. And lastly, at f1.4, we can see it's almost completely dissipated, but again, a nice pattern for the background. And with the f1.4 on my 85 millimeter lens, I'm able to really get some nice depth of field shots without having to move the subject that far away from the background. So that's it for this quick tip. You can control your depth of field obviously with distance, but if distance is a luxury, then control it with the f-stop on your camera. And photographers, if you're new and you're asking, why should I pay for a more expensive lens? This is one of the reasons why. Better glass will last you forever, as opposed to spending the money on, say, for example, the body, which you're gonna swap out every 2, 3, 4, or 5 years. That's it for this quick tip. My name's Terry White. Thanks again, Fallon. Thanks, Westcott. Beautiful Skylux, beautiful subject. We're having a ball here today. We'll catch you on the next video.